Let's see the exercises of this chapter, that is chapter 22. Choose the best answer. You all have to choose the best answer among the given options. Before attempting this question, go through the chapter at least 2 to 3 times. I think you all will be able to do this easily. Coming to question number 2, make 18 sentences. I hope you all can see this yellow box. Some columns are here. So you have to make sentences. Go through the pattern of the sentences. Observe it, how it has been made. So it will be easier for you all to do further exercises of this chapter. Let's see. I think you all can see 4 ancients. I hope you all know the differences between 4 ancients. Again, I would like to repeat here. Generally, we use 4 when we are talking about duration of time. When we are talking about duration of time. And we use since when we are talking about beginning of any event. When we are talking about beginning of any event. So let's see how you all may be making sentences. I have been walking for a long time. She has been reading for 2 hours. They have been waiting for 5 minutes. I have been walking since yesterday. She has been reading since 6 o'clock. They have been waiting since breakfast. So like this, I think you all can make 18 sentences. Please use 4 with these 3 phrases and since with these 3 only. So like this, you all have to practice. Again, I am repeating. Observe the sentences carefully, as it will help you a lot to do further exercises. Coming to question number 3, here you all have to put for or since in the blank spaces. I think you all will be able to do this on your own, as I have told you the differences between for and since. Now the question number 3 is for you all only. I want you all to practice by yourselves first, then I will explain. Coming to question number 4. Read the examples, then fill in the blank spaces in the same way. I think you all can see I have been reading, I have not finished, means using of have been. Just now we have read the same very thing in examples, that is in question number 2, 18 sentences. The examples which we have discussed just now have been. So I hope at least you are aware. Now read the examples, then fill in the blank spaces in the same way. We have to fill in the blanks in the same way, the way it is given in the examples. I have been reading this book for 2 weeks, but I have not finished yet. So here you all can see read and not finish. So first word, from first word we have to fill this blank, and second word we have to fill this. Now let's see second example. I have read this book now and I would like another. Please, we have been waiting for the bus for 1/2 hour, but it has not yet come. Has not come yet, sorry. So here in the box you can see the word read, R-E-A-D. We have used the word read here with I have, and we have used have been waiting. Here a question arises, that how will you know that where to use have been waiting and have read. Its weight use have been and have. Whenever you see, it is talking about time. Whenever you see, it is talking about time. That is for half an hour, for 2 weeks. Then in that cases, you will use have been or has been according to the sentence. Again, I am repeating. How do we know where to use have been and have? So whenever you see, it is talking about time. Just like here you can see half an hour. So we have used have been. Here also it is talking about 2 weeks. So we have used here have been. So whenever you see, it is talking about time. Wait 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 months, 6 years, anything. Then you will use have been. I hope I am clear. Let's me discuss few. Yes, let's see question number D. Here you can see she dashed to sell those apples for 2 hours, but she dashed won it. So here we can see just now, I have told you all will be looking for duration or the time. Here you can see for 2 hours is given, time is given. So here we will be using has been. Here we will be using has been. So what will be the answer of question number D? C has been trying. Try will become trying, T-R-Y-I-N-G. So the answer will be C has been trying to sell those apples for 2 hours, but C has not sold one it. C has not sold. Sell will change into sold, not sold. One thing, I think you all know where to use has and where to use have. But again, I would like to repeat here. Whenever you see the subject is singular, except you and I. Whenever you see the subject is singular, there you all will use has, H-A-S. Except you and I. And whenever you see the subject is plural, that is more than one, there you will use have. Okay, with you also, you all will be using have. With I also, you all will be using have. Means I have been. I hope I am clear on this, on where to use have and where to use has. So in question number D, we have seen here the subject is singular, that is one. So we have used has in here also, here also. Let's see one more example. Let's see question number 8. She dashed the email for 2 hours and she dashed it yet. So again, you can see here it is talking here time is there for 2 hours. So here we all have to use what? Has been and write. So the answer will be C has been writing the email for 2 hours and C has not finished it yet. Two things here you all have to notice. Write has changed into writing when we are using with has been, and finish has changed into finished when we are using with has. So please change the verbs accordingly. If you are using with has been or have been, it will be ing form of the verb. But if you are using with has and have only, then past form of verb will be there. I hope I am clear on this. Now coming on question number 5. Put in all the punctuation and capital letters. You all have to punctuate it. Punctuate means give full stop, comma, semicolon, inverted commas, like this. And also capital letters wherever required. I hope you all are practicing this at your home because it is very, very important. Now coming to question number 6. Check that you remember the meaning of these words and that you can pronounce and spell them correctly. So you have to ensure that you all know the meaning of these words. If you don't know, you should consult dictionary. You all can note down the words in your active English notebook and search their meanings from the dictionary. It will really help you a lot.